Hello, I'm Beth Bowles with the University of Florida Extension in Escambia County, and we are kind of in our wonderful September month. It doesn't really feel like fall yet, and a lot of people are getting excited about vegetable gardening. We're ready to start those cool season vegetables, and according to our guide here, it says that August and September is the time to start those cool season vegetables. But the weather really isn't cooperating, and we wanted to give you some hints so that you're not a little bit frustrated if you start some of these things and they don't do as well right now. Even though this guide, and you look at it for things like collards and kale, it says start in September, you really need to look at the weather instead of your calendar. And so what you have to think of is you can go ahead and buy all the seeds that you like of your lettuces and collards, some kales, and get some specialty things that are really nice and start them. But realize if you put these out in the garden with the heat the way it is in September, you're really going to be encountering a few problems. I have started some of these inside. I have some beautiful little Merlot lettuce right here that's going to be a very tasty leafy type lettuce and that we can harvest when it gets a little bit cooler. But I've been keeping this inside because when I put it outside, the bugs and other things want to find it. So what we do, I've got some kale planted here in the container, and if you've already planted, what you'll notice is that the leaves have insect problems all over them. There's a nice little caterpillar called the cross-striped army worm that has found these, and because it's so warm, those pests are going to be very active. We also have whitefly in this situation, and so on the undersides we have these little insects that are going to suck the sap out of the leaves, and it's really all based on heat. So right now, be kind of cautious that even though your Florida gardening guide says to grow some of these cool season things, remember we really need to go by our weather instead of that. So wait a little bit until we cool down and our days are going to get shorter and some of these cool season things will do well. The good thing about gardening in the cooler weather is you do have so much variety of our vegetables to grow. I have our red Russian kale here, and kale has become so popular over the past few years and it really holds up well in our cool weather. But other options that you can grow, of course, include our broccoli, cabbages, Brussels sprouts, lettuces, even fun things like mizunas, which have a little bit of a mustardy flavor to add some spice to your salads and other dishes. Now remember, these winter vegetables are very small in their seeds, and so when the weather is appropriate, you're going to have to plant them very carefully, either in a container and transplant or here in the garden. Because they're so small, we really don't want to bury them very deeply. And so what we normally do is scatter those in a little furrow that we make. And remember, when they come up, they're going to be a little too close together. And we just lightly cover them and tamp down. We need to make sure we water very carefully and also put a tag at the end of that area where we've planted so we know which vegetable we put. Remember, they all kind of look very similar when you first plant them. So the key right now is to kind of think about what you want for the winter garden. Hold off just a little bit unless you're starting things inside and going to keep them cool. But let those temperatures cool down over the next couple of weeks at the end of September into October, and then there's so much you can grow. If you need more information about what winter vegetables work best for you, contact us here at the University of Florida, Escambia County Extension.